just like you, yes, you, Mike, and our viewers, I see and hear a lot of advertisements online, on television, in the mailbox, on the radio. How else are they getting at me? I forget.
All over the place, basically.
Free Social Security maximization reports, and it's from advisors in various firms around the country. But I've been wanting to ask you this question for a little while. Why don't we ever offer to do that for people at Talon Wealth? I mean, you and I do a radio show together, a video podcast together, and we've never offered that.
We've been missing out, Kristen. I mean, we could have spent all this time.
But I mean, do we not care about Social Security?
Maximization. Yeah, the short answer is the advertising is really annoying to me. It's just that. It's clickbait. It's advertising. What the advertisers know. And these are advertisers for, you know, whether it's a large financial services company or a small financial services company. But what the advertisers know is, hey, guess what? When you're 62, you're eligible for Social Security. When you're 70, you've maxed out your Social Security. There's, 8 years in between. Mm-hmm. And it confuses people, right? Mm-hmm. And they know it's confusing. And they know people are trying to figure out, well, how do I get the, should I take it at 62 or should I take it at 65 or should I take it at 67 or should I take it at 70? And what's the best option for me? So it's clickbait because they know you'll click it. We don't talk about it because it's clickbait. It just annoys me.
But we still need to know it, don't we? I mean,
we do.
Security is a big deal.
Well, it's a concern. And we know it's a concern, and it's something that we do. So for our viewers who aren't aware, I mean, we run a private wealth management company, and we do complimentary financial plans week mm-hmm. after week after week for individuals that are retired or close to it. So guess what? In every single one of those financial plans, we're already doing Social Security maximization. Again, a marketing tool, and yes, it's really important. But here's the thing, Kristen. There's no way for somebody to maximize your Social Security unless you can tell that person how long you're going to live. And without that number, or without that answer, or without that date, right, basically, there's no way somebody can tell you how to maximize your Social Security, because the only way to do it is to know how long you're going to live. And if you knew how long you were going to live, then you would time it just perfect for that date. And then so the reality is sometimes you're talking to individuals when it comes to financial planning about Social Security. Sometimes you're talking to couples mm-hmm. when it comes to financial planning and it comes to Social Security. There are strategies when it comes to it. But if you're working with a true fiduciary who's going to sit down and walk you through the options and run several scenarios, well, what if you took Social Security here? What if you delayed and took it there? What if you took it here and your spouse took it there? I mean, these are the things that get confusing, but it should be a part of any great financial plan. And there's just no reason to have that clickbait out there, like maximize your Social Security. Every time I see that, Kristen, I just want to like, oh, gosh, do you know how long I'm going to live?
You should call the number on the thing.
You know exactly how long I'm going to live? Sure. Tell me how to maximize my Social Security. So are there strategies? Yes. Can you plan around it? Yes. But it's going to be a part of any good financial plan. And you don't have to do the clickbait to get to the answer.
So when our team does comprehensive financial planning, they are looking at 401ks, IRAs, any type of investment that someone set aside. They're looking mm-hmm. for efficiency. They're looking to make sure that someone's getting the value that they're paying for. Sometimes it's pensions, TSP accounts. Sometimes there's annuities involved. But Social Security is also part of the income that we draw from in retirement. So it makes mm-hmm. sense, now that I kind of think this out with you, thank you, that we have it all together in a comprehensive financial plan and not just this little report, you know, that I know that it's OSH, but I don't know.
Yeah, people get the, you can go online and you can get your Social Security numbers and it'll tell you, well, if you took it at 62 or if you took it here, if you took mm-hmm. it at what they call FRA or full retirement age.
Yeah.
It maxes out at 70. And so there's a lot of numbers in there. You can take it early, you can take it late. The basics are the longer you wait to take it, the more you're going to get paid. But then back to the original question is, how long, if I wait, let's just say you wait till 70 and you max it out. Great. Depending on your circumstance.
Health and all those things.
And are you married? Are you not married? Yeah. Would a spouse benefit? Would a spouse not benefit? I mean, there's a lot that goes into it. So it's very particular to the individual. But if you waited, I mean, I'll give you one example. If you waited till 70 and you maximize your Social Security, but then you, God forbid, passed away at 75, you should have taken it at 62 because you didn't make up for all the payments you didn't get from 62 to 70 in that 5-year period, right? So it's, yes, it's there's a lot that goes into it. Yes, anytime if a true fiduciary is actually doing financial planning for you, the Social Security option should be a part of that conversation every single time. But yeah, just be careful of that clickbait, right? The advertisements, come to a seminar. We're going to show you how to maximize your Social Security. No, you're not. No, you're not. I mean, you don't know how old I am. You don't know that. I mean, you can't.
That's true.
You literally at the seminar, you literally can't show me how to maximize my Social Security at a seminar. What you're going to do is try to get me to come back to your office. You know, you're going to ask me what all my assets are. Uh-oh. And you're going to try to get me to buy something is what you're going to do, right? Or hey, click here. We'll run a Social Security report for you. Like, okay. But then you're going to ask me a whole bunch of questions. Mm-hmm. And then you're going to ask me about my finances. And I hope I use my junk email because I'm going to get bombarded.
You know, that's right, not a bad idea.
Yeah, use your junk email.
Our viewers and listeners may not have a junk email address for things like this. That's a really good idea.
Right. The closer you get to 60 or 65, I mean, you've got a target on your back. Get a junk email, right? And make up something ridiculous, just like a stupid name that somebody has to type in every time they
Social Security clickbait, number one.
Yeah, just come up with something crazy as your junk email. And then you'll laugh every time you check it, you know.
But, so there's one way to take advantage of these free reports. Put in your junk email address. Just see what it says. Sure.
If they were out there and they're like, we'll give you $100 to fill out a survey, just do it. Just get your $100. Like, but give them your junk email.
I like that. Yeah. So Social Security clickbait.
Retirement plan. Listen, it's can supplement your Social Security payments with a junk email address. Just do surveys in retirement.
Thank you for watching. Go to guardingyournestegg.com for your free and objective personal financial plan.